Lebanon, a country on edge in the wake of several explosions. At least 9 were killed and nearly 3,000 more were injured, over 100 critically, in an attack that targeted pagers held by members of Hezbollah. Iran's ambassador to Lebanon was among those hurt. The Lebanese militant group is blaming Israel for the blasts, vowing to exact revenge. An official from the group also called the attack one of the biggest security breaches for Hezbollah in nearly a year of conflict with Israel. Hezbollah is an ally of Hamas. Israel has refused to comment on the incident. The U.S. quit to deny any hand in the attack on Lebanon. The Pentagon adds the priority now is to ensure the incident won't lead to a wider conflict in the Middle East.
To my knowledge, there's no U.S. involvement in this at all. Again, it's something that we're monitoring. And in terms of potential escalation, you know, I go back to what I said earlier in terms of a key focus for this department and the U.S. government writ large is on working with partners in the region, to include Israel, to prevent the conflict between Israel and Hamas from spiraling into a wider conflict. And that includes the tensions along the Israel-Lebanon border. And so we'll continue to strongly advocate for a ceasefire and the release of the hostages. And we'll continue to strongly advocate for a diplomatic resolution to the tensions that we're seeing along the Israel-Lebanon border.
The European Union's top diplomat also calling on all sides to prevent further escalation.
Certainly, there is a possibility of the war be spilling over, not only to Lebanon, but also it's already being important fire in the Red Sea, where we, the European Union, has deployed a Navy mission in order to protect the freedom of navigation. The risk of a spillover is not from yesterday, it's from the beginning. And we have to do all our efforts in order to try to avoid the regionalization of the war in Gaza.
Turning now to the race for the White House, Vice President and Democratic presidential candidate Kamala Harris faces grilling by black journalists on her plans if elected president. The interview comes 7 weeks after Republican rival Donald Trump questioned her black identity at the annual convention of the National Association of Black Journalists. Trump's appearance led to controversy over his comments and his treatment of one of the moderators.
I think it's very important to not operate from the assumption that black men are in anybody's pocket. Black men are like any other voting group. You got to earn their vote. So I'm working to earn the vote, not assuming I'm going to have it because I am black. I've had direct conversations.
Both Harris and Trump have made efforts to win over black voters whose support may be decisive in the closely fought November 5 vote. Republican vice presidential candidate J.D. Vance calls for enhanced security for Donald Trump following a second assassination attempt. During a rally in Michigan, Vance criticized the federal government for not providing Trump the same level of protection as President Joe Biden. He also accuses Democrats of placing a target on Trump's back with their rhetoric surrounding the former president.
They want to throw him in prison. They want to kick him off social media. They want to do everything that they can to silence Donald Trump, and they send that signal with every action that they take. Well, if you're trying to silence Donald Trump and you're sending the message, we have to do everything that we can to silence Donald Trump.
At an earlier rally in Georgia, Vance also tried to put a contrast on the statements coming out of their rival camps. The White House, meanwhile, calls the vice presidential candidate's recent statements dangerous.
But you know the big difference between conservatives and liberals is that no one has tried to kill Kamala Harris in the last couple of months.
And when you make comments like that, all it does is create or opens an opportunity for people to listen to you and potentially take you very seriously. And so it's dangerous to have that type of rhetoric out there. This is why this president and this vice president has been very clear on condemning any type of political violence, political rhetoric.
Ukraine denying any ties to the suspect in the latest Trump assassination attempt. 58-year-old Ryan Ruth had publicly backed Ukraine and spent time in Kyiv after Russia launched its invasion in 2022. Ruth had told media outlets in 2023 he had worked to bring in foreign nationals who wanted to fight for Ukraine. Kyiv, however, says Ruth never fought for Ukraine in the International Legion or any other military unit. Ukraine's foreign ministry now urging everyone to refrain from artificially linking Ruth's actions to Kyiv.
Yes, we can see from the news reports that the suspect previously publicly supported Ukraine. But look, there are hundreds of millions of people in the United States who support Ukraine, and clearly they are a diverse group of individuals. We urge everyone to refrain from artificially linking the suspect's actions to Ukraine.
Volunteers and emergency workers raced to secure riverbanks in Poland's historic city of Wrocław as the death toll from the flooding in Central Europe climbs to 22. The deluge has left a trail of destruction from Romania to Poland. Waters have already receded in many areas. But in Wrocław, Poland's third largest city, residents are still bracing for two rivers to burst their banks, with volunteers helping rescue workers heave sandbags to build up broken embankments and secure facilities, including the city's zoo. Authorities have urged residents of several districts to evacuate. Items from the iconic 90s sitcom Friends are going under the hammer this month. In celebration of the show's 30th anniversary, costumes including sweaters worn by Jennifer Aniston and the late Matthew Perry will be auctioned off. Also up for grabs, the famous orange couch and the sign from the show's Central Perk coffee shop. Organizers say this early, bids are starting to come in and they are going way above estimates.
We also have some studio-made reproductions, which were made just for this auction. They're pretty rare, including a full-size reproduction of the Central Perk couch, which is one of the most iconic couches in history. Everybody knows it from the show, from the theme song. So many famous scenes were shot there. So it's a ton of stuff, and any Friends collector is going to be, I think, really psyched to own one of these pieces.